Hi guys, this is Khuan here with another watercolor tutorial. So as you can see right today, what I've prepared is we're gonna paint an eagle today. Okay, so what are the colors that I'm gonna need? Okay, so first of all, I'm gonna use firstly burnt umber, indigo, mainly burnt umber indigo for all the darker areas. Then for the lighter areas, we're gonna use raw sienna. Raw sienna is like a reddish kind of brown, reddish kind of brown for these areas. So yeah, I'm gonna start. First of all, you want to start by get a rather large brush around this kind of size, so that you won't make yourself too, it won't be too troublesome, so just get a larger brush. So the idea is like let's say you're trying to eat a yogurt, you wouldn't use a teaspoon, right? Okay, you'll use a larger one to actually, yeah, you get what I mean, Okay, so I'm just gonna paint, just getting a bit of colors onto it. So what I'm using now is a bit of raw sienna, just for myself to see which areas I've covered in paint. Okay, so you want to keep it pretty wet. Okay, it has to be slightly reflective, because that shows that there's a bit of water on it. You don't want it to be too dry. When it's too dry, right, what happens is that you don't have any time to add any kind of effects or whatnot. Okay, so just wet this whole area, the whole silhouette first. Each time you're just using a bit of, like maybe 5% amount of pigment, very light, but enough for yourself to see. So just a very light hint of color as well. Okay, over here. All right, over here. Okay, as you can see, right, this process, you want to make it wet, but not to the point whereby it's soaking, in a sense that all the, you will see one whole chunk of water there. You don't want that to happen. Okay, so it's just moderately wet enough for yourself to actually add some effects later on. Okay, so I'm not gonna be too ambitious, right? I'm just gonna paint somewhere until one wing first. Okay, so we just stop somewhere here first. Okay, around this wing area. So I'm gonna work on this wing first. Okay, so before you want to start, right, make sure you retouch certain areas by adding a bit of water again to ensure that it spreads. Okay, then what's gonna happen next? I'm gonna apply burnt umber, okay, mixed with raw sienna first. So just create a bit of interesting kind of bleeding effect going on. So I'll throw in the browns first. Okay, so the browns over here along, notice I'm applying closer towards the edges, okay, closer towards the edge over here like this. Okay, this way. As you can see, right, I'm not using a lot of water. This allows it to spread this way rather than all converging to the side. If you use too much water, you find that you won't get much, the bleeding effect won't be so nice and gradual. Okay, so you don't want too much water. Okay, just enough for the spreading to occur, but not too much. Yeah. Okay, so just add a bit of, for this case, the edges, right, I'm painting the tips of each part. So right now I'm using a bit of burnt umber. Okay, so my brush is not really wet, because my paint itself already has some water. So you can see there's some water over here already, so you don't really need to add much water for this case. Okay, so you just grab a bit of paint. Okay, so at certain points, right, you can start to introduce a bit of blues. Okay, but the blue, right, you need to make sure that you sort of overwhelm it with browns again, so that it leans towards the brown side. So I'm just retouching the wing area like this. So I'm not going crazy by painting the entire thing yet, okay, because I want to render one wing first, okay, before I move on to the next one. So notice when I apply, right, I'm applying closer to the tips of each wing, okay, each feather over here. Okay, apply here. Then I'm slowly guiding this pin slowly inwards. Then I just stop somewhere around here. And just move on to the next one. You don't have to paint all the way, because it will naturally sort of like balance itself out. Okay, so just apply around here. Okay, this one is a bit too bluish. Oh, you guys cannot see. Yeah, so it's a bit too bluish for that. Okay, so I'm gonna take a bit of browns to bring it back to the brown side. Okay, and just try something like this. Okay, just get this wing effect more. more obvious, more prominent. Okay, so in the meantime, right, what you can do is just maybe add a few drops over here, just to get a bit of like kind of effect going on, kind of nice effect going on over here. Okay, so for this base layer, right, this is not your final layer, so you can actually play around with a bit of colors, a bit of blending effect. So is this layer that you want to introduce all your very all the granulation, okay, meaning all the very feathery kind of effect at this point. Okay, so I'm just gonna paint this wing first. Okay, so something like this. Okay, then I'm gonna take a bit of raw sienna again to bring back a bit of browns along here. Okay, so this is one wing that I have over here. So just let it dry on its own. Let it dry, learn to move on to the next one. Okay, so for the next one I have over here. So the only part you need to actually take note is around the, when it comes closer to the head, then the feather is pretty white. Okay, so you can see over here it's white, whitish in color. So you want to actually leave that part out first, okay? So you can do either ways. You can actually paint the head first before you paint the body, but for my case I'm just painting the body first, okay? So just use a bit of color, use more water in for this case just to fill up the silhouette of this area. So always your process should always be like water first, dip into the water, then get a bit of paint, then continue working. Okay, never ever let your paintbrush run dry. And also because if you want to always take a bit more pigments, because watercolor, right, when it fades, when it dries, it will fade quite a bit. So you want to make sure that you keep replenishing a bit of pigment so that your painting stays vibrant and interesting. Okay, so this way, like this. So just get the silhouette of the body out first. Notice I'm not painting the other wing yet. Not yet. Okay, so I'm gonna add a bit of darker areas in some places. So areas which I would like to add darker areas, maybe along this area. Okay, just encourage this kind of bleeding effect, okay? This kind of like very, very feathery kind of effect. Okay, so something like that. Somewhere over here as well, I'm gonna just throw in a bit of feathery effect as well. Okay, so I'm gonna create a bit of gradient. So gradient meaning I want this whole stretch over here to be slightly lighter than the bottom. So can you guys see? Yeah, so I'm gonna make the bottom part even darker. Just throw a bit of burnt umber and raw sienna. Okay, so at this point of time, right, I'm not going totally dark yet, okay, not totally like blackish or this kind of area yet. So I'm just laying this layer is just like a base layer for the painting to go on. Okay, so something like that. Okay, but it is in this layer that you want to introduce all your kind of fancy kind of effects. So maybe here I can throw in a bit of darker browns along this area. So it's starting to turn a bit bluish, which I don't want it to be at this point. So I just put in a bit of browns again. So along here. So what I'm doing is like this is the arm of the eagle, right? Okay, somewhat. Okay, you know what I mean, right? Yeah. Then you have a bit of, I retouch certain areas by making it darker. Okay. So certain areas I'm actually adding a bit of, normally I add darker areas towards the edges over here, all the edges, then I start painting towards it, let it bleed inwards, okay, somewhat like that. Okay, then at certain areas, okay, throw a bit of brown again. Okay, then introduce a bit of streaks here and there, because it's slightly dry, right, when it starts to dry a bit, right, then you start to see it retains this, it stays in place, okay, this kind of streak stays in place. So it can be pretty nice effects that you can add at a certain point. Okay, so at the bottom part, it needs a bit more emphasis over here. So I'm going to throw a bit of darker tones along the edges. And notice what I'm doing. I'm actually pulling this paint towards the edge. I'm not really painting inwards. I'm pulling it back to the edge. Pulling it back to the edge like this. So you want to keep introducing this technique to apply, pull to the edge. Yeah, just pulling the paint towards the edge. At the same time, you're maybe cleaning up your silhouette to make it cleaner. make it sharper, because this part of the paper is dry, this part is wet. So by pulling the paint onto the dry area, so you get a very nice clean edge, something like that. Yeah, you can see, right? Okay, so you have a nice clean edge this way. Okay, so I'm gonna move on to the next wing. Okay, so the next wing is it stems from, cannot really see, let me decipher what I drew first. Okay, oh yeah, it's somewhere over here. Okay, so I'm gonna start from here. So the only part that I need to avoid is the head area. So I'm gonna, first of all, I set the boundaries over here. This is where I'm not gonna cross, okay? Then the rest is just block it out. Just block out the whole thing. Okay, something like that. Okay, so same thing for the other side. I always tell my students to like set the boundaries first. So this part, set the boundaries from here to here. Then the rest you can just easily paint it, because watercolor is determined by where the water travels. So if you actually block it this way, they cannot cross onto the white areas. Okay, so just use more water at this point. Okay, so I'm gonna change back to a larger brush. You don't want to, yeah. So this whole point is just from here, right, what I want to create is down here to be lighter, down here to be darker. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna slightly push this across this way to bring some pigments over. Then you add a bit of water over here. Then you repeat the process. Okay. Repeat the process. Then now you want to throw in a bit of color. So I take a bit of raw sienna over here. Raw sienna, just to stain this area. Then I continue working on my silhouette. Okay, just continue working on the silhouette this way. Okay, this way goes up. Goes out this way. Okay, so yeah, so this part is I'm just gonna keep working on it. Okay, make sure that you keep replenishing a bit of water, because it's not done yet. You need a bit of water for some effect to create some effects lah. Okay, so add a bit of water. Okay, so at this point, right, don't be too concerned about all the individual feathers. That's not your main concern at this point. So just get this whole silhouette out. Give yourself about a minute or so to do that. You don't have to drag too long, okay? So something like that. Then, as the wing, as the back is supposed to be slightly darker, okay? So I'm gonna use, right now, my colors is mainly burnt umber and indigo. So I'm gonna throw in a bit of purple as well. So just test around this area, okay? So I just block out this whole area first. Okay, so very quickly, just apply the colors this way. Apply the colors this way. Then add a bit of darker color somewhere around here. Burnt umber and indigo now. Okay. So just let it spread. Okay. You don't want to start spreading this way, because if you do that, right, you are creating a very monotonous level. You want the place to be somewhat darker at certain areas so that it can travel downwards this way. So I'm just introducing a bit of browns over here. Then I'm gonna paint slightly darker into the edges this way. Get a silhouette out. Can you guys see? Yeah. So I'm just getting the silhouette. Notice that I'm not touching all these kind of areas. I'm just letting it slowly spread itself out. You don't have to do too much painterly stroke at this point. Okay, what you want to do is get this very nice silhouette out. Okay, something like that. Once again, I am pulling the pigments towards the edge. Notice from here, right, A, this A, pull towards B, extend. A, pull towards B, extend. 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 Okay, repeat the process all the way. Okay, I'm always pulling the thing to the edge so that I'll get a darker edge over here. So on my left side, right, this part is starting to dry already, so I can actually, it's not 100% dry, so with your same kind of color, you can retouch this area. Okay, retouch the area again. Burnt umber, indigo. It's always the same colors, okay? Retouch, pull towards the edge. Okay, same thing. Okay, guys, see? Yeah. So this part again, towards the edge again. Okay, so right now what I want is this whole part to be slightly darker. Okay, so I'm gonna paint little streaks now. Okay, so watch this. Okay, so just paint lines. Give a bit of space, another line. Okay, somewhat like that. Then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use another color, another brush, a smaller brush maybe. So I'm gonna take a bit of raw sienna just to continue the line work this way. Okay, so just create a bit of pattern going on. Okay, so it'll look pretty decent this way, just creating a bit of texture for the line work. Okay, so next up what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna work on the body. So take a bit of burnt umber, take a bit of indigo. Okay, paint the feathers over here this way. Okay, then you want to darken the wing at the back over here. Alright, something like that. Okay, while waiting for this to dry, right, okay, what you can do is you can paint the other area, such as the other leg now, okay. Or I can paint, I'll start painting in the claws as well. Okay, so this part is pretty dry, so you can actually create a bit of a feathery kind of pattern over here. Okay, so this way. Okay, so can you guys see? Yeah, so I'm just creating a bit of feathery texture over here. Okay, something like that. Maybe a third layer this way. Then this part of the wing, a bit of texture as well. Make the feathers slightly larger. Okay, this way. Okay, then this part is you can create a bit of texture as well, but this part has not totally dried, so I'm just gonna leave it first. So just create a bit of feathery texture. Some parts you can paint into the darker areas, it doesn't matter. Okay, you can paint into the areas which are not wet as well, which are wet as well. Okay, so you can see, right, just now we dot this line, then it's starting to spread itself out pretty nicely. So you don't want to, you actually don't want to manually go and paint every single thing until it becomes overwhelmed. You want to allow this thing to actually spread by itself. Okay, so what I'm going to paint next is the beak and the eyes area. So get another brush. Normally I have like 2 to 3 brushes on hand. Okay, so for the beak, right, okay, it's a bit of I'm going to start with a bit of lemon yellow. Okay, this lemon yellow looks a bit like it's called gamboge. Okay, so I'm just going to paint from here, something like that. Notice I'm avoiding the wing, okay, because I don't want the colors to bleed into one another. Okay, so I'm leaving this very thin line across, very very thin line that doesn't allow the water to travel over. So something like that, maybe somewhat larger a bit. Okay, get a shape out. Okay, then what next? What's next is that you take a bit of orange. Take a bit of orange, just apply to the edge of the beak over here, just the tip, this part. Okay, apply it, then let it make it travel its way back. Okay, so you just pull downwards and let it travel its way back, so you don't really have to blend much over here. So we're gonna paint the eyes now. So for the eyes, I'm gonna use a bit of browns. Okay, so just paint something like that. Okay, here I can let it slowly touch the whites to let it bleed. Okay, paint the eyes this way. Okay, so you can see like the eagle start to come out already, right? Okay, so using the same color that I have over here, I'm gonna get a bit of blue, a bit of purple. So just a bit, so it's very very little. Okay, because we're gonna paint after that. I'm gonna use a bit of Naples yellow as well, just to paint the edge of this tail. So it's slightly yellowish like this. Okay, because it's white in color, but it has a bit of yellowish stain. Okay, so I'm just gonna paint the tail this way. Okay, somewhat like that. Using the same color, you can use it to paint your shadow of the lower part. Okay, just to create a bit of form for the bird. Okay, then for the tail, right, you need to slightly darken it a bit to make it more prominent. Alright, something like that. Then what I'm going to do, I'm going to try a bit of purple color. Okay, so just get a bit of purple. So I'll test it slightly first. Okay, just give it a test first. So it's a bit like very light purple this way, right? Okay, just use it for glazing. Okay, so just glaze upon your your tail area. I'm just going to throw a bit of purple over here. Take a bit of purple over here. Just apply to this area as well. Okay. So over here. Yeah, just a tiny little bit. Okay. Then, now our wing is pretty dry already. Okay, so you can add... you can add multiple layers to make it even darker. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to use burnt umber. Burnt umber, raw sienna, and indigo. Okay, so I'm going to paint this way. Okay, so just watch how I paint, okay? So I'm actually introducing the feathers now. Okay, somewhat like that. Making it darker. Okay, so I'm making this the top part darker. Create a bit of stray feathers towards the end. Maybe somewhat like that. Okay. Then for the top part, you just want to leave a tiny little gap between the next one, the first and the second. Okay, just creating a bit of feathery effect over here. Okay, just continue this layer all the way. So at certain point, right, your wing will start to change direction, meaning the feathers from here, you'll start to do this direction. So it goes, you'll start to point downwards. So you need to direct your, make sure it fans out nicely this way. Okay. So at certain point, you start to point down already, right? Okay. Somewhat like that. Okay, same for the other. So what you have to do is create multiple layers. So this is our first layer, this is our second layer. Okay, just create a bit of layering effect. Layering effect this way. Okay, at the meantime, what you can do is take a bit of salt and just like sprinkle at the top. Around this area, not too much lah. This is just the kind of effect to absorb a bit of water, absorb a bit of paint so that they create a bit of specks here and there. Okay, which might be pretty interesting lah. Okay, so here I'm gonna just paint it this way. Okay. Okay, so something like that. Create a very nice fine edge over here. At certain points, right, you can actually tilt your paper to paint the feather. So utilize the entire brush by pressing down and pull in. Pressing down and pull in slightly. Okay. So as you notice, right, as I paint, right, I'm not replenishing the color because as I paint downwards, the color starts to fade and it creates a really nice gradient from top to bottom. So that's a... So you actually can use that technique. Okay, something like that. So you just create a bit of... Okay, so at certain areas, right, the empty space can be pretty distracting. So I'm just filling it up. Okay, at certain areas, I don't want to have too much space going on. So I just block it out this way. So you can see, right, one wing like that. Okay. Then I'm going to do the same thing for the other wing. Okay. So first of all, I'm going to work from the upper areas this way. Okay, so the same thing. What I'm going to do is take a bit of burnt umber, take a bit of indigo. Apply by layers. Okay, so from the image here, right, what I can see is there's a darker area over here. This part is white, right? So where we are going to start? We're going to start from here, over this area over here. Okay. So let's start from here, this way. Paint downwards a bit. So this is our first layer. Just paint something like that. Go up this way. So this is one layer already. Okay, our first layer this way. Then the next layer is just move downwards. Okay, move downwards. What I can do is I start from here. Okay. 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Then just create. Just keep continuing this pattern. Just continue the pattern all the way till you reach the edge. So, okay, continue. Okay, continue this way. Drag down. Notice I'm leaving a bit of space over here. Okay. Drag downwards. Keep replenishing your colors so that it's more vibrant. Okay, continue downwards. Downwards and downwards this way. So down here there's a bit of gap, right? Okay, here's where you can introduce another layer over here. One, a smaller version. Okay, so get a bit of, making it more brownish. Okay, not too dark. If it gets too dark like this, right, what you can do is just wash away whatever color you have. Get a bit of brown. So you get your colors from here. You don't take from the painting source anymore. You just take from here. Then you start to dilute it. Okay. Then it's back to its diluted version again. So that's, these are like some tips to what you can do if your paint becomes too dark. Okay, just take from the paper itself. Don't keep adding any more paint anymore. Okay. Okay, then next, continue the bottom part over here. Okay, so for some parts, alright, I like the effect that is going on, like this part area. I'm gonna save it. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna work on just the edge, the tips over here. Okay, this part over here. I'm just gonna make it darker, a lot more prominent. Okay. Then slowly let it link towards the center of the bird again. Okay, so just paint this way again. So sometimes, right, what I do is that if I see my image still has some space, right, I'll actually extend it slightly. Okay, extend it a little bit so that it utilizes the entire thing. It doesn't have to look exactly like the image itself. Okay, so just improvise a bit. Okay. So sometimes when you extend it, it can look pretty nice as well. Okay, so somewhere over here. Okay, okay, so I'm gonna leave the wings as it is. Okay, I think it's pretty alright already. Okay, so just get a bit of for this part, I'm just gonna use a bit of raw sienna, just glaze one time like this, just to get a bit of color going on here. Okay, something like that, just glaze a bit of color over there. So this leg, the hind leg behind is not very prominent, so I'm gonna use a bit of burnt umber and indigo to bring it up a bit slightly. Okay, just a bit like this. Okay, that's actually quite a lot. Okay, so using the same color, I can use it to redefine my eye. Okay, redefine the eye area. Something like that. Okay. Alright. Then what you can work on next is the claw. So the edge of the claw is gonna be rather dark, right? Okay, so you can just paint this way. Paint a bit of claw over here. 1, 2, 3. Okay, 1, 2, 3 over here. So a bit of claw, then I just connect the rest with a yellow color. So I get a bit of gamboge color, okay. Then just paint in the whole claw this way. Okay, so it just so the claw doesn't have to look too pretty or what lah. Just create something that will do. Okay. Just I'm going for a very basic looking claw like that. Very simple looking claw. Something like that. Then use the same yellow to touch up certain areas maybe. This way, perhaps around here. And perhaps along the edge of the tail again. Just a slight bit to bring back. Yeah. So with that, I hope you enjoyed today's tutorial, and thank you for watching. Okay, bye bye.